Hi, in this video I'm going to talk you through how to import references from PubMed into Refworks. So I've already done a search for articles on COVID testing and I've selected five of them as you can see for import. So the next step when you've done this, selected your references, is to click on the save button up at the top here. I'll just do that now. So you can see we've got five selected there. And the format you want to choose is PubMed. Okay, it will probably default to summary, but you need to select PubMed and then simply click create file. Okay, and you can see that a text file has popped up at the bottom left-hand corner of the screen here. Hopefully you can see that. Okay, and that is what we're going to use to do our import. So I'm now going to hop over from PubMed to RefWorks. And you can see I've just got a blank page here in RefWorks. But to add the references that we've just captured, I just need to click on the add key here with the blue cross sign. And then simply select import references. So you can see at the top of the screen, it's saying, do you want to import from another reference manager? No, we don't in this case. We want to use the lower half of the screen, import from a file. And it's telling us we can just drop the file here. So I'm simply going to click and drag this file that I know has the references in it that I want into the center of the screen there. And it's just asking me to confirm that that is what I think I'm importing, which it is. So I'm just going to click import. Okay, and it's saying, do I want to put them in a folder? No, I'm just going to leave them outside a folder for now and then decide where to put them. So I'll just click import. And it's done it. So let's just click OK and make sure that they've appeared there in the right way. And those are the references I selected. So that's good. And as you click on each reference, you can see a summary at the side. You can see the full abstract. You've got the DOI and you can click check for full text in order to get to the full text if it's freely available. Or you could get it on interlibrary loan if not. Okay, thanks for listening.